Hey gorgeous people, this is Chris from Macombu and I'm here with the new Lenovo Smart Display. So this is basically a direct rival to the Google Home Hub. As you can see, it does rock a bit of the Google Assistant and a similar sort of style and functionality as well. So I'm going to get it unboxed, set up and show you exactly what to expect. First of all, I need to find a weak point for my bitten down nails to actually infiltrate this thing. There we go, we have found it, we have penetration. Huzzah! Right, now this is the 10-inch model. You can actually get it in an 8-inch, slightly smaller model as well. The 10-inch model rocks this lovely bamboo finish, as you can see on the box. In the case of the 8-inch version, it's a grey model instead. Loving the box, as you can see, rocking that bamboo design through and through. Let's just peel this back and get it up, and there we go. And there is the Lenovo Smart Display in all of its glory. Ta-da! I'll do a full tour of that in a sec. First of all, just check out what else you get in the box. So a little bit of literature, plug, of course, always handy, and a delicious pack of silica gel, and that is your whack, nice and straightforward. Just chuck that away. So we really, really like the general look and feel of the Smart Display. It's got a very funky, angular design, as you can see. It's definitely very modern art. So there we go. So as you can see, your Smart Display just stands there like that. The back end sort of folds out on itself, as you can see there. Very cool indeed, and that just helps to prop up the tablet so you get a good view of it from wherever it stands. Definitely weighs a fair bit, but of course that doesn't matter because it's just designed to sit there on a kitchen top, for instance, and just provide everything you need. We'll take a proper tour of the thing once it's all set up. So I'm just going to go to the kitchen now. All right, so here we are.
Hi,
in the kitchen.
Hi, I'm your Google Assistant. I'm here to help. To get started, please download the Google Home app on a phone or tablet.
Yeah, what she said. So here we are in my kitchen. This is kind of like the family hub of our house. We spend a lot of time cooking, eating, stuff like that, as I imagine most families do. So this seems to be a natural place for the Lenovo Smart Display to set up on. As the Google Assistant usefully pointed out, to get set up, you need to download the Google Home app. You can get it for Android from the Google Play Store. You can even get it for an iPhone from the App Store. And all you need to do is just download that, hit open, and then we'll be able to start the setup. Right, so let's get started. So you'll need a Google account in order to actually use the Google Home app. All nice and straightforward. Location access granted. Okay, so as you can see, I've got a couple of devices already set up. I'm just going to add a new one now. Set up new devices in your home. And just in, yeah, my own. I'm not plush enough to have two homes, sadly. And then there we go. It has found the Smart Display. Excellent. I like it when tech just works, you know. Back in the day, it used to be a case of this video would be about 3 hours long. I'd spend about half an hour on the phone trying to troubleshoot stuff. These days, it's all good, for the most part. Right, so as you can see there, just making sure that you're set up to the right device. Yep, that's all good. And then you can set up exactly where the device is, just for ease of use. So I'm gonna say the kitchen. And then, of course, you can connect it all to the Wi-Fi, and that's how you'll be able to stream a bit of YouTube, a bit of Spotify, whatever you want to do, and of course, access all those Google Assistant features. So as you can see there, nice, simple, straightforward pairing process, and hopefully, with that done, basically our Smart Display will be ready to use. Oh, except, of course, for the obligatory update. Updating. Now, if you're an Android user, you've used the Google Assistant before, you should have some services already linked to the likes of your Spotify account, YouTube Music, whatever you happen to use. But this will just allow you to add those services if you haven't done so already, so then you're all good to go. And then you can set up your default music service. I'm actually gonna set up as YouTube Music because I just have a solo Spotify account. And every time I'm out and about listening to my Spotify, all of a sudden it starts playing Justin Fletcher, some weird like the Nelly the Elephant's Gone to Town or whatever, because she likes to play her music from home. So if we set up with YouTube Music, she can use that instead. Video services, we've got an all four account, nice and straightforward. And as you can see, we can Chromecast to the ensuite if needed. To be honest, I don't really think that's necessary. And then you can set up video calling as well directly through your Smart Display via the Google Duo app as well. I'm gonna skip that for now. Now the ambient mode is basically whatever the Lenovo Smart Display does when you're not directly using it. So for instance, you can have just a clock displaying, or you can get a bit of a Google Photos slideshow on the go. So let's do that. And as long as you actually use Google Photos, then you should have some albums set up already. So as you can see, you can just select recent highlights is a good one to have, because then it's constantly changing. And then just tap next. Stay in the know. Yep, that's fine. Sign up for that. And you can also add a payment method, a credit card or whatever as well, if you're actually directly ordering services via Google Assistant as well, such as ordering in food. I'm going to skip that because otherwise my three-year-old will be ordering all kinds of shiz on the internet. And I think we're good to go. Kitchen display is ready. So on your Google Home...
Welcome to your new smart display. Let me show you how it works. This is the home screen, where you'll find notifications, reminders, and important information, and learn more about what your Google Assistant can do for you.
Let's just turn that down a bit.
Say, hey Google, to get started. You can ask questions, play your favorite music and videos, get step-by-step voice guidance for thousands of recipes, control smart home devices, and more. You can also ask your assistant to complete multiple actions with a single command. This is called a routine. Just say, hey Google, good morning. And your assistant will show you your calendar, the weather, your commute, and whatever else you need to start your day. Want to share the moment? You can video call friends and family hands-free with Google Duo. Also built in on new Android phones and available for free on iPhones. You can connect compatible smart home devices like the lights and thermostat through the Google Home app on your phone. There you can set up news and media, customize routines, and change the ambient mode, which is what you'll see when you're not using your smart display.
So as you can see, after that handy little video introduction, we are now in ambient mode, so it's just going to be showing a nice little slideshow direct from Google Photos. A little bit more about that display, it's a 10-inch full HD IPS display, so it's 1920 by 1200 pixel resolution, so absolutely fine for just, you know, watching a bit of Netflix, checking out your photos, things like that, nice and crisp. You can't directly interact with the screen, as you can see here, so you can swipe up in order to fiddle around with the volume, get to the settings and all of that. If you dive into the settings, as you can see, you can just fiddle with the Wi-Fi, bits like that. And you see there, at the moment it's currently displaying the weather. Looks like it's going to be quite nice this week, hooray, although down to 10 by Friday. Urgh, wrap up warm, kiddies. And as you see, you've got a good bit of calendar action there as well. You've also got direct access to the likes of YouTube, of course, because it's a Google Assistant, and various other bits. But of course, the main interactions are all done via voice. So for instance, you can say, hey Google. Hey Google. Play some Ice Nine Kills.
Okay, try this Ice Nine Kills station on YouTube.
So then it'll play, hopefully. There we go. And as you can tell, the top volume, it gets pretty powerful. But also, of course, it's on that top volume, it's horribly distorted sound as well, so we definitely recommend not doing that. The actual speakers themselves, it's a 2-inch 10-watt speaker, and it's got two passive tweeters in it, so it's all reasonably powerful enough, certainly powerful enough to pump out a good video. If you're going to be listening to heavy rock tunes, something like that, you'll probably notice it's not quite as strong as something like a dedicated echo speaker or something like that, but should be absolutely fine for your everyday home duties. Obviously limited when it comes to bass and things like that, but still absolutely fine, as I say, just for watching a bit of YouTube, something like that. If you want to get rid of anything, you can just swipe it away and then you're back to your home screen. As you can see there, you've got full media controls and everything, so you can stop and start your music, skip a track. And of course, if you pick Spotify or something like that as your primary music service, it'll be playing through that instead. Seems to have completely stopped responding, of course, so that's always great. You do, of course, have full volume controls here on the top of the device, so that's nice and quick and simple. Otherwise, as I said before, you could just swipe up from the bottom and do it that way. You also have a 5-megapixel camera built into this corner right here of the Lenovo smart display. So you can use that for your video calls and everything. You can actually physically block it as well if you're getting a little bit paranoid that it's spying on you or anything like that. And it's quite neat. It does actually pull up a physical shutter as well. So as you can see there, so it's now active. You flick it up. Just pulls up a little physical shutter. You can see a little red dot there that just shows that the camera is blocked from view, so it's no longer active. Really handy little feature. And you can also quickly and easily mute the mic with a quick switch here as well, and it'll tell you the mic is muted. The mic is muted. Job done.
The mic's back on. The mic is muted.
Nice and easy. As for the mics, it's actually a dual array setup. You get a pair of mics here on the right edge, and you get a pair up top here as well. And that just gives you full coverage in whatever room you're in. Now, Lenovo reckons that those mics will work at a distance of up to 8 meters. So I'm across the other end of the room now, and we're gonna just give it a quick blast and see if it'll still work. So, hey Google, Play music.
Playing some music on YouTube.
Hey Google, what's the latest headlines?
Here's the latest news.
Yep, seems to work absolutely fine.
From headlines from BBC News at 6:08 a.m. today.
And even when the Lenovo smart speaker is actually busy playing something at a fairly loud volume, you can just say, hey Google, stop. And it seems to recognize it. Perfectly fine. Excellent. Now, actually running the show, it's a Qualcomm platform. It's the 64 Home Hub chipset. So it's a dedicated platform for this kind of device. And so far, touchwood seems absolutely fine. As you can see there, you just kind of flick about. It seems pretty responsive to taps and swipes and everything. It's fairly basic functionality. It's not like you're gonna be playing PUBG on this thing or anything like that. So it should be absolutely fine for everything you need. And that right there, in a nutshell, is the Lenovo Smart Display. So as I was saying, pick it up in either 8 inches or this 10 inch model. The 8 inch model will cost you 179 quid. This one costs you 229, although I believe there's some sort of special introductory offer available if you buy it right now. It'll be available from the likes of John Lewis and Argos and all the usual kind of places as you'd expect, and of course online. So are you tempted by the Lenovo Smart Display? Definitely an interesting bit of kit. I'll be doing a full unboxing with the Google Home Hub soon as well, as soon as I get a spare moment, so stay tuned for that. And definitely, yeah, let us know what you think in the comments down below. And don't forget to hit subscribe for more on the latest and greatest tech. Cheers guys, love you, bye.